episode 2591 with the end in mind.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop sign,
watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for a party. You've got the Olympics, you got the Super Bowl. Oh my goodness, you're going to have friends and family everywhere. How about the food? Oh no, I know you got good food. So today it's relationship builders. With the end in mind, you got this. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, words have power, especially when attached to the heart. So don't drift apart. Love is patient. Love is kind. Let your words reflect with the end in mind. You know, it's easy to get carried away with words, good or bad. Words can cause your spouse to melt into a puddle of mush or become as cold as ice. You know, with Valentine's Day around the corner, this is a good time to be reminded of the power of words. Valentine's Day is a great day for us only because of the date, not because of the day. It is very much commercialized, and I want to encourage you to look at Valentine's Day differently. You see, my husband and I started dating officially on Valentine's Day, and so we've been together 32 years. Crazy, I know, but it's absolutely amazing, and I look back and think, how have we come so far? And I'm thinking, well, part of it is what we have said to each other and how we have said it, the power of words. Because when you exchange words that pierce the heart, it causes a scab, right? For every bad exchange, the deeper the wound. The deeper the wound, the greater the scab, which leads to a scar. Yeah, you know. Scars are hard. Do you remember riding bicycles? Yeah, I did on gravel roads. Oh, my knees, not so much. Not so good. Oh, no, no, no. Or maybe for you, it was skateboarding or inline skating, or maybe it was softball or baseball or football. You've got a scar somewhere in life. Maybe it didn't even require stitches, but you have a scar. Scars are hard to shake off, right? But scabs, you can. They can fall off over time. But when the threats, hurt, and emptiness fills your mouth, the more difficult it is to escape the words that strangle the heart. Valentine's Day is one that's so, so commercialized. And instead of buying into someone else's definition of love, right? Instead of going and buying all the candy and the flowers, and not that that's not nice, or maybe a beautiful piece of jewelry or something that says, hey, I love you. Define what love is for your spouse this Valentine's Day. Write it down. Don't go spend money on things that really honestly doesn't have much meaning. But when it comes from you, it's huge. So start with the words you exchange with your spouse on a daily basis. What are those? Are they good words? Are they bad words? Are they sweet? Because hopefully they are words that support and lift up, create that superhero feeling for your spouse. You are unstoppable, baby. You got this. Even though maybe at times they don't feel it. Yet you need to be honest with how you really speak to your spouse, right? There's got to be that balance, that fine line as to how you lift up and also how you show them love in truth. You know, there are tendencies to shrug our shoulders and just let our tongue attack even when we don't mean to. We let loose and whatever comes out is just that, whatever. No restraints, no concerns, no love. When you feel secure in your relationship, harsh words flow easier because you're just in the comfort and security of each other. And quite frankly, if you're to that point, then you know what? You're taking your spouse for granted, but that's all for another episode. Part of the words, right? How you phrase things, what you use, good or bad, they can be extremely beneficial. But if you let it all go all the time, how much of your trash can your spouse bear? How much can your spouse carry around? All your trash talk. Yes, you should be able to share everything. Good, bad, and the ugly. However, if you want to continue to build a strong foundation in your marriage and deepen your relationship with each other, you've got to tame your tongue. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Tame the tongue. You know, 1 Corinthians 13:4 says this, love is patient, love is kind. But do we even start with that anymore nowadays? I mean, seriously. I know, because man, my tongue, whoo, I could lash out so quickly and not mean to. But you see, it's family. It's my husband. So it's okay, right? Because he said, I do, for better or for worse. So guess what? I'm going to give him the worst because my day was horrible. Yet I treated everybody else fine. But with him, oh, no, no, no. I'm just going to let him have it. And it wasn't directed at him. It was just in the moment. And he was just in the crossfire. How unfair. So we really need to understand how to tame the tongue. Understand where love comes from. Love is patient. Love is kind. This is what you can do to leave a mark on your marriage for the rest of your life. And it's a testament to your love for each other. Tame your tongue. So what does that look like? T-A-M-E. Number one, T, tickle with kindness. Your words should just have this Shazam of kindness that comes out. You know, my grandson just got back from visiting and spending a few days with them, and he loves to do raspberries. You know what raspberries are? Okay, let me move the microphone away from this because it's going to sound horrible. All right, you know the raspberries. It sounds horrible, doesn't it? I'm so sorry you had to hear that. But I wanted you to be in the moment. So when you do that, it tickles my tongue. Have you ever done a raspberry recently? Okay, maybe not. But when you have a grandson, you do anything for them. You just do it. And so I think about tickling with kindness always. It is that Shazam, that energy, that burst of flavor in your mouth. Yeah, you know Skittles? Have you ever heard of the candy Skittles? Oh, I'm sure you have, right? It's the rainbow. You pop it in your mouth and it's like, wow, it's this burst of flavor, right? So tickle with kindness. That's what your words need to have at all times, because you know what? They're always going to be received better. Even if it's criticism, when you have it attached with kindness, oh yes, the heart softens and the ears lean in. Okay, so remember that. Tickle with kindness. Number two, adopt a position from love. Let love lead your tongue. You know of WWE? Well, for us, it's WWM, World Wrestling Marriage. You don't want to wrestle in the bad sense of the term. You want to wrestle, wink, wink, in the good sense of the term, right? So adopt a position from love. If you're sitting there going, gosh, I don't know how he's going to take this, then maybe you need to stop for a moment and think about how you can phrase it so it can be received well. I think when we come from that and we serve from the heart and our words come from a well of love, then it changes everything. Tickle with kindness, adopt a position from love. Number three, M, magnify the positive. This is where you're seeing your spouse as if Christ is seeing him. Okay, so that means you see with the eyes of Christ. Lead with forgiveness. Don't have a stern heart. Have a forgiving heart. We need to understand that we all fall short every single day. So just because your spouse still leaves the toilet lid up and still has his clothes of piles on the floor and won't fold his laundry, and still you have to trip over his shoes every single daggum time you walk in the door, guess what? There could be a lot worse things you could be fussing about. Put it in perspective. Magnify the positive, right? See your spouse the way Christ sees him. And finally, number four, E, engineer your phrases to speak the truth with little scarring. Notice I didn't say scabs, because there's going to be some scars. It just is a fact of life. My husband and I have been together for 32 years. Do you think all of our words have been filled with tingling tickles of kindness? No, they have not been. Some of them have been lashes and slashes going right to the heart. And I mean, just piercing in a negative way. Don't you think that leaves a mark? Of course it does. But can it heal? Yes, it can. But you have to engineer your phrases to speak the truth with little scarring, right? So you speak with the end in mind. So at the end of the day, you want to have your spouse's heart wrapped in your love, all from words, which is incredible. But that means you have to think about it. That means you don't sit there and just go blah and vomit all over them all the time with whatever comes to mind. It doesn't work that way. When you meet somebody brand new, think about this. You go for your job interview. And even if you're working at home or you're a stay-at-home mom or stay-at-home dad, guess what? You remember, go back to a first job interview. You go and meet someone, right? Do you sit there and vomit and say, oh my gosh, how dare you wear that color of tie? It just looks disgusting. That does not go well with your color. And your hair, you really need a better haircut. Do you seriously say that to them? Now, maybe after the interview, you're talking to a good buddy of yours. You may have that conversation or your girlfriend, right? But when you are meeting the person for the first time, you're not going to sit there and just say, oh my gosh, I can't believe you look like this. You would dress like this. How dare you have your hair look like this? But you know what? That's what we do to our spouses every single day. And how unfair is that? How unfair? So we've got to start thinking before we start speaking. Engineer your phrases, right? And that means, yes, you're coming from love is patient, love is kind. Wrap it up because you want your words received well. And remember this, your words are not for you. So they must be mastered for your spouse. Remember English class? Yeah. Most of us in the world, yeah, we don't like English. And if you've ever had to take a college English, you're like, why am I learning to write this way? Exactly. Well, consider this English 101 for marriage. You've got to tame your tongue. You've got to be speaking to your spouse. Your words need to be reflected for the love of your spouse with kindness and forgiveness, so that they can be received well on the other end. So I want to challenge you today. Yes, this is your Valentine's Day challenge. What words can you tell your spouse today that will surprise him in an uplifting way? Go back maybe if you have to and think, gosh, what did I tell him when we were dating? Maybe you have some old letters around. Or, oh my goodness, if I actually am saying this, maybe it's old text even. I'm back to the old letters for me, but for you, maybe it's old text. But what was it? What were those phrases? What was something that meant so much to him or to her? My husband has his wallet, and there's this piece of paper in it that I wrote to him years and years and years ago. It's a yellow post-it. Remember those good old-fashioned original yellow post-its? Uh-huh. You know what I'm talking about. Well, I would go to his office and I would visit and I would bring him usually a drink. His favorite drink is, you know it, Pepsi. And so I'd bring him his fountain Pepsi drink cold in the afternoon and he would be into, you know, later in the evening working. And so I would leave little notes. But this one day he had a really bad day. I didn't know it. I hadn't seen him. I dropped it off and I left the office and didn't see him until later that evening. To this day, he still has that note with him in his wallet. Words have power, my friend. We need to be able to speak life into our spouses. Because you said, till death do us part. Don't let your words be the end of your marriage. Let it be the building of a true, incredible, strong, foundational relationship that can withstand the test of time. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Hey, have a happy Valentine's Day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.